In this video, we'll talk about how to find a basic feasible solution, or BFS, to the balanced transportation problem using the northwest corner method. There are three steps. In step 1, we need to find the northwest corner cell of the transportation tableau. Then we allocate as much as possible to the selected cell and adjust the associated amounts of supply and demand by subtracting the allocated amount. In step 2, we will cross out the row or column with zero supply or demand. If both a row and a column have a zero, randomly cross out one only. In step 3, if exactly one cell is left uncrossed, cross out the cell and stop. Otherwise, we need to go back to step 1 and repeat the process. Now let me explain the method step by step using an example. This is the transportation tableau. The total supply for the first row is 5. For the second row is 1, and so on. The total demand for the first column is 2. For the second column is 4, and so on. Now in the first step, we need to find the northwest corner cell of this tableau, which is this cell. We need to allocate as much as possible to the selected cell and subtract the allocated amount from the supply S1 and demand D1. The largest amount we can allocate is 2, because if we allocate more than 2, D1 will be changed to a negative number. We put a number 2 here and subtract it from D1 and S1. D1 will be 0, S1 will be 3. This is the new tableau. In step 2, we need to cross out the row or column with zero supply or demand. In this case, only D1 is 0. We will cross out the first column and remove D1. Now we need to check step 3. Do we have only one cell left? No, we still have many cells left. We need to go to step 1 and repeat the process. Now we need to find the northwest corner cell in the remaining tableau, which is this cell. We need to allocate as much as possible to the selected cell and subtract the allocated amount from the supply 1 and demand D2. The largest amount we can allocate is 3, because if we allocate more than 3, S1 will be changed to a negative number. We put a number 3 here and subtract it from D2 and S1. D2 will be 1, S1 will be 0. This is the new tableau. We need to cross out the first row and remove S1 because S1 is 0. Let's continue with the process. Find the northwest corner cell in the remaining tableau, which is this one. Allocate as much as possible to this cell and subtract the allocated amount from S2 and D2. The largest amount we can allocate is 1. We put a number 1 here and subtract it from D2 and S2. D2 will be changed to 0, S2 will be 0 as well. This is the new tableau. S2 is equal to 0, D2 is equal to 0. We have a tie. In this case, we randomly choose the column or the row to cross out. I just choose to cross out this entire row and remove S2. Continue with this process. Find the northwest corner cell in the remaining tableau, which is this one. Allocate as much as possible to the cell and subtract the allocated amount from D2 and S3. The largest amount we can allocate is 0. We put a number 0 here and subtract it from D2 and S3. D2 is still 0, S3 is still 3. This is a new tableau. D2 is equal to 0. We will cross out this column and remove D2. Repeat the process. Find the northwest corner cell in the remaining tableau, which is this one. Allocate as much as possible to this cell. The largest amount we can allocate is 2. We put a number 2 here and subtract it from D3 and F3. D3 will be 0, F3 will be 1. This is the new tableau. D3 is equal to 0, we will cross out this column and remove D3. We have only one cell left. We just allocate the remaining amount, which is 1, to this cell, and cross out this row and this column, and remove S3 and D4. This is the final tableau. Remember, this is just a basic feasible solution. It's not the final optimal solution to the balanced transportation problem yet. How do we interpret this basic feasible solution? It means x11 is equal to 2, x12 is equal to 3, and so on. All other xij in the blank cells are equal to 0. If you wonder if this really is a basic feasible solution, you can check whether it satisfies all the equality constraints. Let's bring back the original supply and demand. The sum of the first row, 2 plus 3, is equal to 5. The sum of the second row, 1, is equal to 1. The sum of the third row, 0 plus 2 plus 1, is equal to 3. The sum of the first column, 2, is equal to 2. The sum of the second column, 3 plus 1 plus 0 is equal to 4. The sum of the third column, 2 is equal to 2. The sum of the last column, 1 is equal to 1. So all the constraints are satisfied. This is indeed a basic feasible solution. The advantage of using the northwest corner method is that it requires least computational effort. The disadvantage is that it does not utilize the cost information, and thus it may yield a basic feasible solution with extremely high cost. More simplex pivoting iteration will be evolved later. Okay, this is how we find a basic feasible solution to a transportation problem using the northwest corner method. Thank you for watching.